Hello. I shaved off all this stuff. I kind of liked it when it was here because it hid the fat, but it was ugly. So here I am with the beard gone, just a mustache. But that's not what I want to talk about. I've been daydreaming for years now of going camping. But I'm here in the city and I can't go away overnight, really, because I have to stay and watch over my mother. That's my job these days, is to make sure she's healthy and she has enough to eat and she has clean clothes. And we got this thing now where the nurse comes in every week and checks her vitals. But last visit, day before yesterday, they said, she's too healthy. We may have to drop her from this program. Okay. But she doesn't want to go to the doctor. She doesn't like to get in the car and drive down there and wait and walk around. Well, maybe she could be in our outpatient, but Medicare won't like it. It'll be if she's in the inpatient. I'm like, okay, what can we do? So that's an issue, and I definitely can't just go out camping in the backcountry for 2 or 3 days and leave her alone. No. It's just to go to the store for an hour is worrisome, because she's out in the front of the house right now. Used to be the garage, but now it's the laundry room and it has the computer in it. And she's playing solitaire. She's happy. And she's so damn healthy that I'm happy. So I've been thinking, okay, what if I think about San Diego and the history of San Diego and trying to sharpen my filmmaking skills by making short videos about the history of San Diego? Well, except for the translating class, which my grade has dropped to 92 out of 100. I'm not doing as well as I thought I would. Except for that, I really have no worries, for which I am grateful. This month of November, the season of Thanksgiving, I give thanks that I, although I'm obese, am relatively healthy. And my mother, although she's 97 years old and frail, she is healthy, of sound mind, and reasonably sound body. So I give thanks for that. And I also give thanks for the inspiration that maybe I should just focus on the place where I am. Not daydream about going out there into the mountains of the backcountry and the deserts and traveling from San Diego up to Maine, although I'd like to do that one day. Drop in and see Frank and Lori. But now, focus on San Diego and what it means to be the corner of the United States, this bridge between Mexico and England, English and Spanish. I'm running out of time. 5 minutes is coming. Goodbye, my friend.
Meanwhile, the United States moves swiftly to reinforce its garrison in the Far East. 1,200 Marines marched to their transports at San Diego on their way to war-torn China. Again, this was a preview of things to come. In 4 short years, American troops would once more pour overseas by the millions. It was the time for tearful goodbyes, the time for family ties to be broken, no matter how hard the task. The curtain had risen on decades of war and strife.